The first protocol for quantum key distribution that we will consider is the famous BB84 protocol. This protocol uses a special class of states, namely the BB84 states. So what are these states? There are four of them, and they're the elements of the standard basis, plus the elements of the Hadamard basis. And the elements of the standard basis are the eigenstates of Pauli Z, and the elements of the Hadamard basis are the eigenstates of Pauli X. If you look at the Bloch sphere, then these states are here for the standard basis and here for the Hadamard basis. We will also talk about BB84 measurements. These are just the measurements in these two bases, namely the standard and the Hadamard basis. There's one important property of BB84 states and BB84 measurements. We had two bases, standard and Hadamard. If I prepare a state in the standard basis, say 0, and I later measure it in the standard basis, I always obtain outcome 0. So if I prepare a state in the standard basis and I measure in the standard basis, I can perfectly recover for what the state is. Similarly, if I prepare a state in the Hadamard basis, for example, plus, and then I measure it in the Hadamard basis, I will always get back plus. So I will always recover perfectly what the state is. So in general, if I take a state, let me label that state X, and I encode it in a basis, so the basis, we will always call this here theta being 0, and the Hadamard basis theta being 1. So these basis elements are 0, 0, and 1, 0 for the standard basis, and 0, 1, and 1, 1 for the Hadamard basis. Then if I encode a bit in the basis theta, meaning I pick the corresponding vector to X and I choose the basis theta, then if I also measure in the basis theta, meaning that if I picked standard, I measure standard. If I picked Hadamard, I measure Hadamard. Then I always recover exactly X. What if I measure in the wrong basis? So what I mean by that is that, for example, I prepare in the standard basis, but I measure in the Hadamard basis. Let's compute the probabilities that I obtain outcome 0 if I say measure in the standard basis, but I prepared in the Hadamard basis. For example, I prepared a state plus. So if we compute this, we will find that what we get is that this probability is 1/2. And similarly, I compute this probability, 1 plus, you can also find that this gives me 1/2. And this just comes from the fact that plus is the equal superposition between 0 and 1. So if I prepared a state in one basis, but I measure in the other, we get that both outcomes occur with equal probability. Interesting case for us in the protocol will be that if I pick measure in the same basis as I prepared in, I get the same outcome. If I measure in a different basis, I get a random outcome. There's also other states which are often useful in quantum cryptographic protocols. You can find out more about them in the lecture notes, and these are called sig states. So what are these sig states? The sig states are the BB84 states, standard and Hadamard bases, plus two additional states, namely the state which I will call 0y and 1y. We call these states 0y and 1y because as the BB84 states are the eigenstates of the Pauli X and Z matrices, it turns out that these are the eigenstates of the Pauli Y matrix. As with BB84 measurements, we also speak about sig state measurements. And these are just the BB84 measurements plus the measurement in this additional basis. If you think about the Bloch sphere, then these sig states are not in the XZ plane. So here is 0, here is 1, here is plus, here is minus. But instead, these states are the eigenstates of Y, so they lie at the right and the left of the Bloch sphere. The BB84 states and sig states are very useful for constructing quantum protocols, and we will use them for much more than just quantum key distributions.